So I've been mowing this area that grows some pretty good grass. I keep it mowed and I make these mounds with the clippings. I just use my zero turn over there to mow it. Once it's all mowed, I rake everything by hand with a big rake into piles. And I just do this one square. You can see from those piles to this pile, basically right out to here is where I mow. And I rake everything into piles. These piles are a couple of months old. They've composted to straight up hay. And this is what I use in the chicken coop and in the goat pen for bedding. Then once the goats go to the bathroom on it and it gets soiled with their manure, it is perfect compost. Goat manure is compost ready for a garden immediately. You don't need to let it compost or at. Their manure is immediately usable. You can use their manure straight up, but they pee a lot with it, which makes it wet and stinky. And that's why I suggest mixing it with a little bit of soil or dirt, 50-50 mix. Really good for all of your garden needs. Now, with the chicken compost, it's hot. So what I do is I put the chicken manure after I clean out their chicken coop, I put it around trees, stumps, bushes, and it will fertilize. A hot fertilizer of chicken manure is good for bushes and trees. I'll show you what I mean. So when you're picking up chicken waste from cleaning up the coop, what you can do is take it and surround it around your trees. It is a hot compost, but it's okay for trees and bushes and shrubs, not okay for a vegetable garden. You'll have to let it compost first. One of the things that it does is it provides invitement for bugs. I don't know what the word is, but bugs like to go into the chicken poop as it's composting around trees and roots. And what that does is it provides food for the chickens, because the chickens will eat it. They'll come through, they'll scratch it, and they'll spread it out. You really don't need to spread out the manure. You can just dump it in the barrel. If you don't want to get your hands dirty, you don't want to wear gloves, you can just dump it and kick it with your boots. And then, as you can see, the chickens will come over and they'll scratch it and spread it for you. So you don't have to worry about spreading it too much. Just dump piles around it, and all around the trees, they just spread it out for you. And this is good fertilizer for trees to keep them strong so they continue to provide shade for the chickens and the goats in the summertime when it gets hot. All right, so I have the chickens and the goats integrated. They all eat the same feed. Again, as I've said before, goat feed is good for chickens and goats. Chicken feed is not good for goats. They love it, they will eat it, and they'll get overstuffed on it, and it can eventually cause death because they'll not stop eating it and they'll get gout and they will just blow up like a balloon. So even though they like it, it's not good for them. So never let your goats eat chicken feed. If they eat a little bit that spilled on the ground, it's okay, you're not in trouble. But if they eat a lot of it, like they were to get out of a trough right here, you might have a problem. So remember, goat feed for your chickens and your goats is absolutely fine. It's really good for them. Chickens will eat anything. Goats will eat anything, but shouldn't. So we're getting ready to fill the nest boxes. And the chickens in the coop, they love to roost, they love to make nests, and they love to kick the hay out of the nesting box, which is such a huge problem with everybody. So if I take a little bit of hay, for instance, and I go ahead and I put it in a box and I'm like, hey, look, here's a nest for you. Let's see if we can get one to go in there right away. They're gonna, out of curiosity, check it out, and they're gonna start scratching it and pulling it out of the box. So they're gonna go in there and she's scratching and looking for food, not treating it like a nest. Look at her scratch. She's already starting to kick and remove half of what I put in there just in this time that I've been talking to you. Now she has two accomplices that are gonna help her out, get in there and say, what did you find in there? Because a chicken is really monkey see, monkey do. If one chicken does it, they all want to do it. So what do? You want them to lay eggs in the box so you know where the eggs are to pick them up, and you don't want them laying down on the ground here and searching for eggs and going, where's the eggs, where's the eggs? So maybe they're out by the tree, maybe they're here. Well, that's what these are for. These are ceramic eggs. I've numbered them number one and number two. And that way I can see what one is producing best. Do they like the milk cartons, or do they like those milk cartons, or do they like these boxes over here? So they really don't go into those boxes too much. Some of the hay is still in there, but we can see that they're kicking this out now. Let's move them out of there. Come here. Out, out, out. I'm going to put them all in here, right? And she's going to try to go right in there while I'm doing this. But what I'm going to do now is I'm going to place the egg in there, right? I'm just going to put that egg right in there. And I'm going to push the hay out like it is a nest already. And I'm going to put that egg in there and see what they're doing. She's going to peck at it. She's not too sure about it. And this is going to train them to sit on eggs to try to hatch them. We're going to find out which chicken is Brody and which one isn't. A Brody chicken, for those who don't know, is one that likes to just sit on eggs. And she sees an egg, she'll actually steal eggs and bring them over to her nest and lay in them. But what they're not doing is they're not removing the hay. They're too curious about this egg and what's happening. So some of them don't know. They're also about 2 weeks away from actually laying an egg themselves. So I'm just gonna see what they're doing. They're all very curious about the egg. This one is trying to take the egg out. So this is what I need to pay attention to. I need to see what they're doing as one of my goats attacks the wheelbarrow. Sassy, stop it. You can't turn your back in here for nothing. She's not interested, so I'm gonna get these brown ones out. My bet is one of them, one of these darker ones is gonna go in there and try to do it. The brown ones, I don't know. We'll just have to see. So I have this other egg. Now let's see if I put two eggs in there, if it matters. Two eggs and see what they think. Now it's a little strange because none of these chickens have laid eggs. They don't know what's going on. So my bet was right. One of the darker colored hens is actually laying on the egg. So this shows me that this chicken right here is probably going to be a Brody hen. This is going to be the one that wants to hatch him out. She's trying to make her nest. She's fixing it. She wants to sit on this egg right. She thinks that it's her egg. And she's going to sit there and protect it. So very interesting to see. Now I put another one up here to see what will happen to it. This one is number one. Number two is down below. And we'll see what happens. Now I'm curious to see what this black one is trying to take it on her, what she's going to do. She's just sitting there and she's not going to move. She's not fully sitting on it though, you know what I mean? She's just sitting there ignoring the other bird. So, very interesting to see how she'll act. And she is not moving off that egg. She's just going to sit right there. So the black chicken is just giving up, like, okay, I'm not going to do nothing. And now the other one's going to continue working on the nest. So we'll have to see how it goes. I'm just going to keep throwing some hay. I put them some boxes down here. I put some up here for them. I like to just scatter it everywhere. They hang out, even though they knock it down. But you never know. This is what I have to deal with. I don't know if you guys can see it. I'm going to try to zoom up in there. Inside the alfalfa feeder is chickens sitting up inside the feeder right there, right above Sassy behind her. Now Honeybee is trying to look at them with her head. Bonus footage. I went ahead and I attempted to fix, and I'm saying attempted because I haven't tested it out yet, but the water pipe burst has been dealt with. On this side of the barn is where we had the burst, and I took some extra PVC pipe that I got from a neighbor And we ended up putting it up there because they didn't have the parts of the store. Of course, everybody's still hoarding PVC pipe in Texas and it's hard to come by. So we're using spare parts. To dig this up, pull the cap out. There's the valve. Check for any kind of snakes or anything. And don't see anything. And this is the valve. It's a little wet down here. There's a lot of extra sand. And I always like to just dig that sand out just because it shouldn't be packed in there. I packed it in there for the freeze. Freeze is long gone. Make sure that this valve is off so I don't get popped in the head. Okay. I'm gonna go ahead and lock it because that was an air release. That's a good sign. Now, let's see the moment of truth. And I hear water bursting. So let's go see where we have water bursting. That's where we have a leak. So that is a massive leak. There's a crack in the pipe, and I will have to fix that, so total fail. This was the pipe that was bursting, and we saw it jet out the other side. There was a crack in it, and I just didn't cut down low enough. So what I did is I looked at it really good, and I think I cut the part that was still cracked out, and I re-put another sleeve on it right there and connected it. So hopefully all cracks are gone, and now we should be okay. Up here, what I did is it's just a valve, which is shut. So any future date, we can go ahead and open this. Oh, if I can open it. Open it, and then we have water. We'll gush out of here. I can put an elbow here and run it to the self-feeder if I want. Or I can start the self-feeder over here on this hose. So that valve's shut now. We shouldn't have a leak. I don't know. Let's go kick the rooster off the valve, open it up, and see. We have an explosion. Are you ready to turn the valve? Are you ready to turn the valve? Everybody gathering around, take a good look. All right. So, and water's on. I don't hear anything. Water's on. Is everybody happy? Water's on. This will make my job easier in giving you guys water. Let's take a look. I don't see any water. Oh boy, nice and dry. The ultimate test. Are we ready? And we have water. It works. I'm not opening that full blast. I will get a shower, but it works. Some of them will just let you pick them up. You come underneath them and just pick them up and then they're on your hand. And they try to balance on your hand. Go on, get on the cart. Get on the cart. Go ahead. Off my hand. Don't poop on me. Go. 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 Jeez, didn't want to leave my hand. But anyways, and of course they all come into the coop now because they all want to be like, hey, what are you doing? You know, when you feed them and you're always doing that, that's what happens. Sassy still has not had her baby. She is getting sleepy and lying down a lot. Huh, Sass? Are you sleepy? Is that baby on the way? We want to see this kid come. Are you excited too? Honey bee, are you excited? Honey bee? So honey bee is excited. Sassy pants over there. Just have the baby already. Good Lord. Anyway, baby goats. And I need to get some bottles and all that because I want to milk her. So we're just waiting. She should have it like any minute now, any day now, any week now, any month now, maybe in a year. Just, God, come on, have the baby. I don't know. Anyways, all right, guys, that's about it. I'm John with JCB Farm and Garden. Till next time, bye-bye. God bless.